Welcome back to Nuzlocke Season 7, Episode 5. This episode, we're probably gonna die. Rest in peace, Cluesman, shut up, Rick, who had no idea that I was in full diamond, and we're doomed from that point onward. Was Clues just not a type? I forget. Hold on. Yeah, Clues wasn't a type. Interesting. Actually, where's flying? 900, 150. Interesting. So flying has been caving all game. Cabby's probably flying. I can't remember if Cabby took damage at the start of the game. Well, no, hold on. Yeah, it's probably Cabby. Which, obviously, is not good, because Cabby Rabby's good in this game. Man, I actually really fucking like this game mode, not knowing what types everybody are, and then the people who don't have a type, you can't fucking know who they are. It's fucking crazy, but it's fun at the same time. So I hope people enjoy watching it just as much as I, amongst other people, most likely, enjoy playing it. Cause yeah, this is, like I said this in the Nuzlocke chat earlier, actually. I think this is my favorite in terms of playing, my favorite season of Nuzlocke, overall, because it's just because of all the, like, mystery and stuff to it. Like, I love game modes like that. It sucks that I can't really find, like, a true way to, incorporate any mystery-type thing to Desire, because, I mean, the sort of thing that we did, I mean, I guess, was the, I guess in Season 6, I suppose. Whatchamacallit, what was I trying to fucking say, dude? In Season 6, hiding the list of scenarios was not, like, a huge mystery thing, because there's obviously only a selective list of scenarios that we're gonna run. Okay, there are way too many fucking mobs in this cave. I'm just gonna shoot them all to death, because none of them are gonna live. There's a skeleton around here too, I saw it. Yeah, there it is. There's two skeletons. So that... Oh yeah, I said I was trying to go for Sharp 4, I should continue on that quest. Probably can do that somewhat soon as well. Because it's... Actually, it's probably a lot of fucking levels. I'm trying to think if anybody I killed, or anybody that I killed had a diamond sword, but I can't seem to remember if anybody did or not, so hopefully nobody did, because I'm gonna feel like an idiot if somebody did, but I guess I'll find out later. When I upload this and everybody tells me, oh, you're a dummy, so-and-so had a fucking... three diamond sword, and you threw it out because you have the same thing. In which case, I would agree, because you're 100% correct. Avoid the other two mobs, go straight for the fucking skeleton. I somehow did not take damage here. That was a miracle. What the fuck? That should not have happened, but it did. I was very impressed by that, given fucking 1.8 mob AI is not the greatest. Zarky's been on 3 hearts the entire fucking time. If I can find out what type Zarky is, Zarky's dead. Like, I swear, for the past few episodes, him and Michael have been 25 and 50. Okay, 16 gold now, that's 2 yaps. Let's keep grinding. 25, 26, and then it goes back down, please. Yes, it does. Thank you. It's granite. Keep going down. Don't do this. Why do you do this to me, game? Come on. That's... when your girl fucking agrees to having sex with you and then instantly realizes that she's on her period. That's basically what that cave just did to me. I'm sorry, that was probably, like, extremely, awkward and cringy and shit and not funny. But if that did make you laugh, then good. Because that's my objective. I'm loving it. Oh, don't sue me, please, McDonald's. I like your food. Most of the time, anyway. Except when you're stupid as heck and you make my thing wrong. Which, my thing being a fucking 10-piece chicken McNugget, because the only thing that is good from McDonald's is chicken McNuggets. I'm sorry, I saw bones and thought it was like a sword or something. Like the tip of a sword of somebody like shifting. I also didn't have to use both my pearls on brick. Actually, maybe I did, I don't know. But either way, using both of them was definitely worth it. Y22. I just have to go up with fucking 3 gaps, which is kind of annoying, but it is what it is. If I killed Brick, he would have given me 3 gaps, so I would have had 6, which I would have been much more comfortable with. I mean, like I said earlier, if I just pearled on Brick initially instead of shooting at him, I'm sure I would have killed him. Fuck. Oops. Oh well, now I have 2 fucking gaps. Incredible. This is why I stopped playing this game, dude. It's terrible. Except at the player killing part, because apparently I'm good at that. Until I fight Cappy, of course, because I'm probably gonna die to Cappy or Tommy. Those two typically tend to be huge problems for me. Kinda wanna just ask Fugano if he wants to come sacrifice to me so he doesn't die to land. But I'm not gonna do that. Is that silly? I hate when lava is above me, dude. Because I think that's where this lava is right now, unless I'm being led to another pool. Yeah, it is definitely above me. Fuck off, dude. It's a waste of lava. Come on, Notch. Or Jeb, or whoever fucking coded these useless lava pools. Why you gotta do that? I think they literally made these things just so that people who break the fucking number one rule of Minecraft fucking die more often. I'm convinced that that's the only reason those things exist. Because I don't know about you, but in real life, halfway through the crust, I was never told that there are pools of molten lava ready to fucking kill you. Also, another game I started playing recently, PlayerUnknown's Battleground. I'm sure some of you have heard of it. It's actually very fun. I played with, Riker and Parker Gilmore, aka Blissens. And, I think I played, with Daniel too, Daniel Sherba. So for those of you who are interested in where Daniel Sherba is, he is still around, he just doesn't play Minecraft anymore. And he obviously does not upload videos either, because you would know where he is if that were the case. Man, my caving luck really just took a blow after finding all these fucking diamonds. I think all my luck in the game just really took a blow after I found the dibs stuff. Like, that was, like, probably the major thing. I don't know if I want to go for fighting or not. Fighting's like crazy. You have to kill like 20 mobs with your fist. I'm not doing that. What the hell? I may just go up and try and fight people. Honestly, Zarky's gonna die. Let's see if Zarky is flying. Yep, he was. I knew it. So Cappy was probably ground? Or fire? I don't know. I don't know if Cappy even has a type right now. Who knows, Mango? But yeah, Cappy is a huge threat. Took no damage from Zarky, so. Rest in pieces. I got 8 different types? What? That's crazy. It's absolutely wild. Oh, that's probably why his health disappeared. He just wanted to get every type. I should cook stuff really fast. Although now that I'm on the surface, it's gonna be easier for people to hunt me down. So hopefully nobody does that, because that would be disappointing. Bang bang. But yeah, back to basketball things, I suppose. I keep touching on that and then forgetting about it and then coming back to it. I think the NBA is an interesting organization to host professional basketball, because once upon a time, they were not soft, and now they're super soft. You tap a dude on the arm while he's fucking shooting, and it's a foul. Like, that's a little bit stupid, but... And then there's also the allowance of the fucking super teams being the Cavs and the Warriors. Both of which are really extremely stupid, dumb teams, by the way. Classic flus. It's just a bunny hopping around. I hate bunnies, dude. Okay. Here's official gap number 1 in my inventory. I should put that there. Actually, where the fuck do I put gaps? Here we go. That order works for me. Dude, why are all the bunnies in the game stalking me? What the hell? Give me that, and then give me this. And then I have 2 golden apples. Which is really not that good, but... Should I try and hunt people down now? Pokemon Ditto list. I feel like everybody in the game almost has a type. You know what? Cappy is psychic. I'm gonna just guess that right now. Cappy's probably fucking psychic. Which is not good. Because my armor does not... Great. Okay, at least Emily did damage to Cappy. I'm gonna guess that Cappy is psychic. Oops. What? What are you talking about? Witch hut here. Is flying taken? Because I might just release ice and get flying. Very tempted. I don't know why I'm not using this. Because there's literally no reason not to use it, really. Ice is incredibly fun to use, too. But yeah, I probably have to fight Capirappy to win the game, which is gonna be great, because it means he's gonna win. Likely, anyway. My gold luck has just gone out the window. It's unfortunate, but it is what it is. And I suppose I can try and cave at, like, 0-0. Because, I mean, I certainly have the ability to, with all the apples that I have. I feel like Cappy's just hunting down every type in the game right now, so hopefully he's not coming after me next, because I'd like to keep my face alive. Actually, I wonder if Cappy even has full diamond. There's a chance that he might not, in which case I would be happy. But at the same time, he also probably has at least power 3 with psychic abilities, which is not fun. Thought I just saw a person, but I suppose I didn't. Yeah, I said I was gonna try and go for sharp 4. I should do that. I don't know if I can do that right now, but I can try. So yeah, let me find out where Cappy is. 900, 340. Psychic's probably Tommy, honestly. I feel like it's fucking Tommy. Or it's Mydoza, one of the two. Or Len. Yeah, because Len said I hate the person who has psychic type, so it's probably, yeah, it's Len. Len has psychic. I'm just gonna guess. Just to throw people off. Yeah, Cappy's probably fucking psychic. I hate my life. Fuck, what was I gonna do? Oh yeah, I was gonna try and make sharp 4. I'm dumb. Doy. I've been talking about doing that for a few fucking minutes now. Sharpness. Can I get a sharp book? I cannot. Let's try and make another sharpness sword then. Sharpness, I can. Give me another book. Give me another book. No. I don't need the power book, but I'll take the proj book. Power, come on. Sharpness, there we go. Throw these two out. Put this together. Let me put something on that there, just because. Do get into a fight with the psychic type. That means I can get away or sort of take somewhat less damage by having at least one piece of projectile 2 diamond armor. I really hope Cappy doesn't have that much diamond armor, dude. I'm gonna be sad. I'm gonna guess, what type is Cappy, dude? Cappy's ghost. I'm guaranteeing Cappy's ghost. Probably not ghost, but I'm gonna say that he's ghost, just for the sake of making the assumption. In fact, ghost type does fucking destroy this shit. Okay, Sid was slain by Flues, normal. Is in fact Sid Garcia. I had a feeling, because Sid healed back up way too fast. That's because he healed 2.5 hearts per golden apple instead of 2 hearts. Which ultimately, if you heal 4 times, it gives you 9 hearts, which is about what he did. Why are there so many villages, dude? There's literally villages everywhere. That's what I don't understand. Is there a person in there? Oh no, the villagers are just talking to each other. Minecraft is weird, dude. Alright, well, there's the end of the episode. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you all next time.